This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is example 26 of solving an equation containing fractions, and this is quite the doozy, this one, all these fractions. But we won't have any problem. We're going to use the method of multiplying by the least common denominator to eliminate all the fractions and get an easier equation. So we have to decide what's the least common denominator here. Look at all the denominators. We have 3, we have 2, we have 4, we have 6. So you have to figure that out, and hopefully you got 12. So what I'm going to do is multiply both sides by 12. So I'm going to multiply the left-hand side by 12, and let's multiply the right-hand side by 12. Make sure you distribute 12 to all the terms. So I have 12 times 2/3 x plus 12 times 1/2 equals 12 times 3/4 x plus 12 times 5/6. All right, and if we chose the right common denominator, then we should end up with an equation that has no fractions. So 3 goes into the 12. I love this method, getting rid of all the fractions. 12 goes into 2 6 times. 4 goes into 12 3 times. 6 goes into 12 2 times. Then we carefully multiply all these. 4 times 2x is 8x. 6 times 1 is 6. 3 times 3x is 9x. And 2 times 5 is 10. So we've got an equation without fractions. Now, 9x is bigger than 8x, so I'm going to put the variables on the right-hand side. So I'm going to subtract 8x from both sides. And if you do that, notice you just get 1x on this side. So I don't want to have the plus 10. I like to do this all in one step. So I'm also going to subtract 10 from both sides at the same time. It's up to you whether you want to take 2 steps to do that or not. But that way I'll have just an x on the left-hand side. And 6 minus 10 is negative 4. And we usually write that answer as x equals negative 4. All right, so we're going to check to see if negative 4 is the correct solution. So I have 2/3. I'm going to replace x with negative 4. And I'm going to write that as negative 4 over 1 plus 1/2. Now I have to get a common denominator here. Notice I'm going to get a denominator of 3 on the left, right? So I've got 3 and 2. So the least common denominator is going to be 6. So I need to write each of these with a denominator of 6. So I need to multiply this fraction by 3 over 3, and I'll have to multiply this fraction by 2 over 2. And that will give me a negative 16 sixths plus 3 sixths. So let's see, that will be negative 13 sixths. So the left side simplifies to negative 13 sixths. Remember, when you're checking, you just have to be very careful with your fractions. You can't multiply both sides of the equation by something. That's not checking. So now we're going to plug in negative 4 on the other side. And the 4's cancel, so this becomes a negative 1. But I need to get a common denominator of 6, so, right, because I just have a 1 in the denominator over here. So I'm going to have to multiply this fraction by 6 over 6 to get that common denominator of 6. So that gives me 3 times negative 6, so it's negative 18 6 plus 5 6. And that will give me a negative 13 6, so it does check. So what does that mean? This is our solution right here. X equals negative 4 is the correct answer. If you're going to use solution set, The more formal notation, you would put it inside the braces. So again, the arithmetic of the check usually is a lot harder than solving the equation in the first place. But it's good to practice your arithmetic, so that's the advantage of checking your work, besides, of course, making sure you got the correct answer. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.